In a previous video, we had the great pleasure of launching the SCREWFIX socket from MK, and we'd like to respond to some of the questions that that video threw up. What are we going for, Gordon?
The main one was, Gary, some electricians thought they could still tighten screw terminals faster than these screwless terminals. So that meant only one thing. We'd have to pass it over to one of our tame electricians, who's currently the leader of our electricians challenge. So it's time to hand this socket over to Ross Sands.
Swinging into the commentary box to join me, it's the Indiana Jones of the electrical industry. How are you doing, mate?
Very good. Well, let me start by explaining the challenge we have in front of us. We have pre-stripped those 2.5 millimeter solid conductors in the dado rail trunking, and all Ross has to do is connect them to the screw terminals in the first half of this challenge and the screwless ones in the second half of the challenge. Don't have to screw the socket back to the dado trunking, so we are literally comparing the time it takes to connect screw terminals to screwless terminals.
Yeah, we've removed any variables. The stripping variable, putting the front back on, it could be a case you drop a screw, and it isn't a direct like-for-like comparison between screw and screwless socket outlets then. We're on the first one only completed, so it's going to take some time to get through these five.
Yeah, so we have seen Ross on the channel before. If you haven't seen Ross in action on our Electricians Challenge, well, I recommend you check that out. If you would like a go yourself, he is the person to beat and has been for some time. We did have some other contractors in as well. Gary, have a crack at the challenge as well, didn't we?
Yeah, so this is not, obviously there's 10 people had a go at this. We can do a comparison with just one person. And it was interesting, those results that came out of it. But as we're going through here, we still don't know whether he's going to be quicker with the screwed terminals or those screwless ones, do we? But I'm sure in our own mind, we probably already got a conclusion.
Yeah, we had a go on them, and we found them to be pretty quick. I know what option I would go for. But what about that other question we get back from people, Gary, that other comment when it comes to this type of terminal?
Well, it's de-skilling the industry. So, of course, as electricians and tradespeople, we want to make our life as difficult as possible. We must have, I don't know, rebelled against removing the use of a horse when automotive vehicles came along. We rebelled against the use of battery tools, maybe electric tools before that, because all of those things were maybe de-skilling our industry, making it easier. Nobody wants an easy life at work, do they?
No, that's it. I just get up in the morning and think, actually, I want to have a really difficult day today, so I put the Wago 221s to one side and search down at the wholesale counter to see if they've got any of those old brown junction boxes you used to have on the ring final circuit, Gary.
Yeah, absolutely. And you think about those Wago 221s and the equivalent family of connectors, they're a little bit more expensive than those chalky block 5 amp, 15, 30 amp connectors. But nobody bothered because we fell in love with them. They're so easy to use and they make a fantastic electrical connection. But we're still hearing people rebelling against moving away from a screw. Those people who go to work on a horse, I would suggest.
Yeah, and we'll see that play out as this range develops. Hopefully we'll see these terminals in other things such as light switches, such as fuse spurs, such as the metal clad sockets.
Well, I think the next logical place it should be going is inside a consumer unit. I don't see why we're doing screws in there. We could be in there, obviously, with our screwless terminals. I think we've also explored that, haven't we? Our good friends on the continent are already doing it, aren't they, Gordon?
They are, Gary, yeah. They almost laugh at us when they see some of our electrical equipment because they've had screwless sockets and have had screwless consumer units for some considerable time.
Wow, it's about time we caught up then, isn't it, as we move towards this screwless adventure that we've all imparted on thanks to MK. So just these CPCs to go in, all five socket outlets will be completed. These are the MK Logic Plus sockets, so we've gone again like for manufacturer as well. And Ross is just about to press that button in about 3 days and 2 hours and 26 minutes.
Whoa, just before we get into Ross taking on the screwless terminals on this SCREWFIX socket, Gary, the other comment we got back from a lot of viewers was they're struggling when it comes to price point.
I would suggest those people probably aren't MK users in the first place, but there is a chance to jump in because we've reviewed the MK base range. We've done a deep dive into that range. We'll leave a link in the description to the three videos we made on that, and it gives you a chance to, say, level up your installation by installing MK electrical accessories. But let's not waste any more time. Let's jump over and see how quick Ross can be when screws aren't involved. So I'm not flying solo in this second commentary session. Yes, I'm joined once again by the Indiana Jones of the electrical industry.
Yeah, I don't know where you get that from, Gary. But here we go. Ross is into the screwless contacts of the MK SCREWFIX here. And I suggest the name somehow gives it away. This looks pretty rapid to me.
Yeah, and just a quick word of warning there, you don't need to lift all three of the levers, say for the line, neutral or CPC, in order to make one or two connections. It's just, I think Ross is finding it quicker just to lift them all and find a hole and push it in.
Yeah, you're saying he's got sausage fingers there, Gary. Is that what you're somewhere suggesting?
I would suggest a little bit of moisturiser wouldn't go amiss. He's also a keen off-roader on his motorbike, does that at the weekends. I think those hands are signs of a bike that's been apart many times.
Yeah, that's it, but it's not holding them back here. Again, dead easy, these sockets, just lift the lever up, push the conductor in and close the lever, that is it.
As you're watching this, would you suggest to yourself your mind's going, I'd rather be screwing them down? Is that what your mind's telling you?
No, I'm thinking this could be the future. I think a lot of people will like this approach.
Yeah, so do I. And I'm sure it's going to be in a wider range. I'm sure MK will put it into the fuse connection unit, the light switches, etc. as we move forward. It's in the socket outlets at the moment and we can already see the massive benefit that those connections are making. You know, they're all at the same torque setting effectively, aren't they? The tension of those springs are all the same.
That's it, yeah. Pressure, Gary, we've got a CPD coming out on torque. It's rotational, nothing to do with lever connectors.
Okay, so everything's the same. So every time you put it in, okay, nothing's gonna obviously break over screwing connectors. Yeah, I've done it before myself, haven't I? I screw too tight into a conductor, it can break. That's where we get our open ring final circuits when we're testing. Yeah, I would suggest.
I think we're on the last one here.
Just about going to be done. That looked quick. I think Ross has left us in no doubt there with his two times. The screwed time versus the screwless one. That looks about a 50% saving to me.
Yeah, so if any electricians out there think they are still quicker when it comes to using screw terminals compared to the rapid fix, you are more than welcome to pop up and have a go at our electrician's challenge. You may even beat Ross.
And we did have more than one person take on that challenge. We showed that one. We actually had 10 contracting electricians from here in the Skipton area attempting it, didn't we?
Yeah, we did. And Ross was the fastest, and we had, but all times were similar when it comes to that time saving. So when
you say similar, all of them were faster using the rapid fix socket.
Yes, absolutely.
There's one more thing we want to have a look at on the back of the socket that people brought up. It's those two test points, isn't it?
Yes, it was. Yeah, people said, how do I test the socket? Because obviously you can't probe onto screw terminals. But if you look, MK had thought of that. There are two test positions there where you can get a small tip probe and access the live and neutral terminals in there.
Okay, they've thought of everything, I would suggest. However, it's still be a case that you do not want to go over to the screwless socket outlets. It might be the price point that's causing you an issue. And that circles back to this, the MK base range. And I strongly recommend they check out those links in the description. As always, we'll be interested in your feedback. Can you leave it in the comments below? We'll try and get back to as many as we can.